We have been busy, distracted, hustling, working, building, and living. But then it happened, and everything changed. A darkness spread, a darkness no one saw coming. Now we wait. We wait and we grieve. We grieve for those who lost their jobs. We grieve for those whose business closed. We grieve for those whose life savings has vanished. But mostly we grieve for those who are suffering and those we lost. And we wait. We wait with our kids. We wait with our spouse. We wait alone. We are homeschooling, working on the front lines, and watching. And we ask, will we ever be like we were before? The answer is no, nor should we be. It is in our darkest moments, those times of great pain, when we are tested and our true character is revealed. And maybe right now, you and I are exactly where we need to be. Because what matters most isn't where we are or what we were, but who we are. Maybe what matters most isn't what we do, but who we do it with. And who we believe in. Suddenly we are not divided but connected. Every man, woman, child together with one cause. It doesn't matter where we came from, what language we speak, what nation we call our own. Today we are a family in a giant world that just became small. So we stop. We pause and we hunker down to save our neighbor, our town, our city, our world. We do this not for the strongest or most resilient among us, but for those who may be vulnerable. And for them, we gladly wait. For when the sun rises and our doors swing wide open again, we will be changed. Changed from the intensity of our endurance. But now, what was neglected is stronger. Our faith unwavering, our hope compelling. When that day comes, we will take what we have learned, the wisdom we have earned, and we will build again a stronger people, a stronger nation. Because on that day, we will be scarred, but scarred beautiful.